how do you use color and music and sets and costumes, these expressionistic elements of old school movie making, how do you use those to tell a story, an emotional story, a sweeping love story, but updated in a way that felt modern while marrying the musical to real life.
Hearing his vision of this movie and of this world really instantly was very interesting to me.
I was really excited by the fact that Damien wanted to make a film in the style of the sort of musicals from the 30s and 40s. He wanted to sort of have the film have that kind of aesthetic and spirit and sensibility.
David Wasko works with his wife Sandy Wasko, and they are just the most inspiring duo. They designed Pulp Fiction, they designed Collateral.
Damien, he actually drew this chart that started with peaks and valleys where he showed he wanted to go from reality to then heightened reality.
I just heard you play, and I wanted to sleep.
What blew us away and really struck us about David and his wife Sandy is their passion. They are like 25-year-old kids. They are just so wide-eyed and hungry, not only to please, but to sort of push the ideas further and to bring color and dynamism and detail.
I love it.
They were people who reveled in the challenges of this as a movie, and they reveled in what they had to build. Everything from subtle little touches like lampposts that we would make sure were peppered throughout the movie, all the way through murals that we'd have painted, to more obvious builds like the planetarium set.
Why don't we heighten and take the deco flavor of the outside and just weave it into the inside? There's a new projector in the planetarium right now, and the old one, we found a used one that we're able to rent, so we have the real planetarium projector that was put on a turntable.
In a way, it's why you do a musical. Only a musical really allows you to fully express that emotion. You can't express it with just traditional realist cinema. So yes, they do literally fly into space, and then in the epilogue set,
they float out into this fantasy of LA and their life that could be. It came from sort of the magic at the jazz club where the two of them are thinking about an alternative ending where they have gotten together.
Most of the movie was shot on locations, but every location was thoroughly designed, altered.
We sort of enhanced it and brought it into contemporary, but with a little twist.
What kind?
It's a Prius.
I mean, that doesn't help me.
The world at large is a world of a musical. The stuff that isn't sort of bright and poppy is still heightened. It still has an element of fantasy, even if the performances inside of some of those places are a bit more grounded and real.
In all of our interiors, we would really create the whole world, and then the camera can point to anywhere.
The Waskos blew my mind. The very first day was the roommate's number. And walking into that apartment was just, I didn't know there was gonna be a billboard-sized Ingrid Bergman on my character's wall, and I was like, well, here we are, this is the world we're in.
You got the invitation, you got the right address. You need the medication, the answer's always yes.
What we do is create this quiet background world that helps tell what the character is about.
The challenge for them was to create an entire world, but to create a world that was baked into real life.
Someone in the crowd will take you where you want to go. If you're the someone ready to be friends.
There was a new set location every day. And once we got into the tempo and into Damien's vocabulary, it became sort of easy to move through it.
It makes LA just look like the most beautiful, glittering jewel box you've ever seen.
We stumble on a view that's tailor-made for two.
We were painting
beautiful,
with paint.
Yeah.
Mary was painting with her fabric.
For 2 days, we went through the film scene by scene, myself, the Waskos, and Damien.
Just going through every single moment of the script, purely talking about color.
If there's a Mount Rushmore of costume designers, Mary Zofries is on it.
It was really about using costumes as an expressive tool and using the colors of these costumes as an expressive tool.
That's very much a Damien thing. The use of color and to make it strong and impactful it is a solid color. And he's right about that. It makes a bolder statement and it's more instantaneous. It's immediate.
The misconception sometimes is in order to have a colorful movie, you just throw a lot of color at it. And actually, if you throw a ton of color on a canvas, it winds up not seeming colorful because the colors just start to muddle each other. You have to pick a lane, basically. And so that's what we've tried to do for every single shot.
They fit into the palette and the color and the technicolor and the timelessness and the presence of the movie. It's fantastic.
Timeless with a contemporary sensibility is absolutely what we were going for.
When you look at her clothes, you know a lot about each of the people wearing them.
I know you look so cute in your polyester suit.
It's wool.
You're right, I'd never fall for you at all.
Everything was so incredible. It felt like we were all bringing this very specific thing to life.
The idea for Mia is that she starts off, it's a lot of vibrant color, and there's a girlishness to her. And as the movie continues and as she becomes more mature, the color starts to become less important. It's a little bit more desaturated, like to the point where she's in her one-woman show and it's literally black and white. And then we see her 5 years later, and it's the same girl. She's more sophisticated.
Here's to the ones who dream foolish as they may seem.
Those costumes help inform your character a great deal.
Sebastian, he's a little bit older than Mia is. This is his look. This is what he's been wearing for a while, and it's not necessarily trendy. It's not necessarily what every other man walking down the street wears. It's something that he's developed and curated. He buys quality, not quantity.
It's hard with this film to have it have the sensibility of the 40s and of those films that it's paying homage to, but it's also set in contemporary times. So we had to find a way to walk that line so that they didn't feel like they just stepped out of a time machine.
Mary is just this incredibly gifted stylist and historian of cinema.
She has this strictly contemporary understanding and a really deep and rich understanding of history and the way in which clothes have evolved and how that could be married in a way that didn't feel too retrospective nor too connected to today.
She truly is one of the greatest costume designers alive.
I should probably tell you something now, just to get it out of the way. Mm-hmm. I hate jazz. Are you okay?
What do you mean you hate jazz?
It just means that when I listen to it, I don't like it.
It had to really ultimately stem from the character, so it was really important to me to tailor it to the character and the specific actor. Marry the old with the new.
You really feel like you've sort of traveled back in time to another era, even though it's still contemporary.
It's not actually just about escaping from reality. It's about using dreams and fantasy to comment on reality and to hopefully articulate even better than a realist movie could what it feels like to fall in love, to have your heart broken, to have a dream, to follow a dream, what it feels like to be human.
Crazy as they may seem, here's to the hearts that break, here's to